Hello friends, welcome to yet another session of R. Today we learn how to create own functions in R. We have already seen R has large number of inbuilt functions like choose, which is used for combination, round to round off the values, sqrt for square root. So similarly, we create our own function today. An R function is created using the keyword function. Fine. So let's see how to write a cube of x. If we want to write a function which can give us the value of cube of any number, so let's see. Let's define the function name, that is cube. We have to write function, then we have to write the parameter which we will enter. Like in this case, whatever the number we enter, we want a cube of that. So there is only one input variable, let us say that is x. To write the function, we will write in curly brackets. So whatever the code we write in curly bracket, that will run when we run this function. So what we want the cube of this x. So x multiply by x multiply by x, this is what we want to get back. So control enter. So now this cube function is created. So now if we write cube bracket one variable, let's say 3, control enter, see, we get the result as what? Cube. Even if we enter a vector also, let's say 2, 5, see, we get the cube of both the numbers 2 as well as 5. Fine. Similarly, we can create a function for simple interest. Let's say si is my function name. Let's write function. To calculate the simple interest, we need more than one parameter values. Like for simple interest, we need the principal value, we need interest value, and similarly we need the number of years, right? So we write in curly bracket. So what we need to multiply this principal into interest into the time and return the value. Fine. So let's see, simple interest of principal 100, rate 5%, time say 2 years, control enter. Sorry, we have not put the control enter in simple interest formula. Okay, see, we get the interest part. Fine. Similarly, you can write the function for present value of annuity also. So let's say PV is my present value of annuity. How many parameter we should have? Just guess. So we need 3 things: the amount of annuity, interest, and the number of years. The formula for this is C into bracket 1 minus 1 plus I raised to power minus n. Please take care of the brackets. This is my numerator part. I put one more bracket, divided by the time, interest. Fine. I think we have missed one bracket. Okay, we have to close this. This is extra. Fine. Okay, I have put C capital here. Let's make C small here. So I think I have 1 minus this bracket is there. Okay. There's one more bracket. This is extra. Okay, now this cross sign is gone. So please take care of brackets in this. Control enter. So let's find our present value of 100 rupees when the rate of interest is 10% and for 10 years. We need control enter. See, this is the formula. This is the present value we get. Fine. So in this way, you can write the functions of your own. Now, let's see the matrices part. How to write a matrix in R. So let's say I have one variable m1 in which I want to write a matrix from say 1 to 9 number. The function is matrix only. So first we write the numbers. Let's say we want to have 1 to 9 numbers. So it will 1 double colon 9 will generate a sequence of 1 to 9. Then I have to define how many number of rows I want. Let's say we only need 3 rows. How many columns? We need 3 columns. Fine. Semicolon M1. We want to type this. So see, we get the matrix from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. See, by default, the numbers enter by the matrix is on a column wise. If you want to have numbers row wise, then we have to add on one extra number, extra term. Three, we can write directly also. There is no need to write n row. That is just I written to make you understand. Now make it by row. By row. T stand for true, or you can write in capital words, complete, semicolon, m2. Now what it will do when I run this, like in this it is filled column wise, then it will show the result row wise. Now see the difference here, the number entered is in column wise, now it is entered in row wise. So that is why by row true is very important. Let us suppose we want to enter this matrix now. Fine. So how we enter this matrix, let's see. See, remember one thing, if you are entering the column wise number like 284, then it's fine. Otherwise we have to write the by row true. So m3 matrix now. As there are more than one number, for vector we have to write C. Now enter the numbers column wise. 284, see, we have 284, then 5 minus 1, 3, 5 minus 1, 3, and the last row is 6, 4, 1, last column, sorry, 6, 4, 1. Now just define one thing also, the number of rows are 3. It will automatically take number of column as 3. Control enter. See, this is what we have there. 284513641. So this is what we got it here. Now there are certain commands of this. So we want to get a dimensions of this. See, dime 3, 3, this means what? M1 has 3 rows and 3 columns we have, right? Now we want to transpose, let's say M3. We want to transpose this matrix. So for transpose, we use TM3. So if we select this and control enter, see, the row become column. See, 284. This is column here. Now here it become a row. So transpose, we have T. To get the number of rows, number of columns, we have this. Say number of rows in M1 is 3, number of columns are 3. To get the determinant, that is used for determinant. Say all right, this is give you the determinant. make it C. Determinant of M3, if you remember determinant, how we get 2 into 1 into minus 1 minus 4 into minus 3 minus 8, you left this row and column, 5 into 1 minus 6 into 3, and plus 4, you left row and column, 2 into 5, 6 minus minus become plus. Like this we use to find determinant. Fine, that is the value of the matrix is known as determinant. Now, next command is very, very important. Diag M1 give you the diagonal elements of M1. So, let's find the diagonal element of M3 here. So, M3 diagonal elements are what? 2 minus 1. Oh, sorry, not this. Yeah, 2 minus 1 and 1. So, when you make it this, see, it will give you the 2 minus 1 and 1. Next, to get the identity matrix, that is also very, very important. So, we'll write, see, identity matrix is a square matrix. So, if you write, say, diag 4, it will create 4 cross 4 identity matrix. Fine. In similar way, we can find the sum of M1, two matrices. First, let's get again M1 and M2. M1. Sorry, M1, M2. See, these are two my M1, M2. If you find the sum, see, it add the respective elements of the matrices, right? Similarly, if we make it M1 minus M2, see, it subtract the respective elements. See, 1 minus 1, you get 0. See, 1 minus 1, you get 0, 4 minus 2, you get 2, 3, 7 minus 3, you will get 4, like this. Similarly, if you make it M1 square, see, this is my M1, 1 square, 1 square, 1 was there, 4 square, is your 16, like this, every element. But see, when we M1 star M2, there is a problem. See, in matrix multiplication, we multiply the first row with the first column, and similarly first row with the second column and the first row with the third column to get the first element. Sum of all this is my first element. But here it multiplied the respective element. So, if we see, so basically, see, this is my M1, this is my M2. 1 into 1, it giving me 1. 2 into 4, it give 8. But this is not matrix multiplication. So, this is the wrong result. Okay. Similarly, to see, to get rid of this problem which I told you, we will write the multiply sign in percentages to get the actual multiplication of matrices. So, if you make a control enter, see, this is the actual result, which is matrix multiplication, right? So, let me show you. So, what we do, we multiply this one first row into this 1 into 1 plus 4 into 4 plus 7 into 7. So, it is 1 plus 16 plus 49, which is equivalent to your 66. So, this is our first element, like this. This is this multiplied by this column. Fine. See, this is what we got when we have 66. Fine. Similarly, if you see M2 multiply by matrix multiplication is not commutative. So, see, you get a different result. Fine. M2 multiply by M1. So, when you multiply M2 by M1, So this 1, 2, 3 will multiply by 1, 2, 3. Fine. So like I show you, 1 multiply by 1 plus 2 multiply by 2 plus 3 multiply by 3. So this is 1 plus 4 plus 9, which is equal to 14. Fine. This is what we got. Fine. Okay. How to solve inverse? To find the inverse of matrices, we have command solve to get the inverse of matrices. So let's see, check the inverse part. Control enter. So this is what we get, the inverse of the matrices. Fine. Let's check the result of this. If we multiply the inverse with the matrices, we get the same identity matrix. So let's multiply this. So this is what we have. So let's round off this to get, see, once we round off, because these number are what, 1 into e to power 0, 0 almost 1, this is almost 0, e to power minus 17. Fine. If you want to change the row names, see, we have m1, see, right now it is 1 2 3. Now I want to make a one in place of 1 2 3, I want r1 r2 r3. So see, the command is row names, see, r1 r2 r3 in place of 1 2 3. To get the column names, we have call names, and this is representing, in bracket we write the matrix name in which we want to apply that column names. So let's check, see, we get r1 r2 r3 and c1 c2 c3. Fine. Let's see the indexing in R matrix. See, m1 1 comma, see, in vectors we have only one element, so it is one dimension number, so we write only the number of element. But here are two dimensions, so first is representing row and second is representing column. So 1 comma represent what? All the elements of the first row. Let's see. See, the column 1, 1, 4, 7. Fine. See, this is what we get, the row 1. Fine. Comma 1, this is, that means we are not selecting a row, we are just want to check the column part. So it will give you the result 1 2 3, the first column numbers. See, the control enter, we get that first column number 1 2 3. 2 comma 2, that means second row and second column. So what we get, we get the result 5. When we apply -1, that means except my first first row and except my first column. So except this and this, we get what, 5 8 6 9. See, 5 8 6 9, and this is vector c12 means what, first and second row, first and second column. So see, first and second, first, second, first, second column. So it is 1, 2, 4, 5. We got it. Fine. These are some of the sum function. You know, this is a outer, is basically a fun function. This will give you the outer numbers like this. We have R1, R2, R3. So these are my first, this is my row numbers 1, 2, 4. And this is my column numbers. And this is a fun function plus. So what it will do? It will give the matrix resultant with first, it will add the first row and number, column number. Like I'll show you. See, this is 1, 2, 4, 1, 2, 4. The first number is addition of the this and this, 2. 1 and 2, 3. 1 and 3, 4. 1 and 4, 5. Like this. 2 plus 1. Similarly, you can make a fun function multiply also. So you will give the multiplied part. See, 1 into 1, 1, 1 into 2, 2, 1 into 3, 3, like this. Fine. See, let's, there is another very important function called cbind. What does cbind do? It combine two vectors. C stand for column wise. So like I have one vector c1 2 3, so like I show you, this is my one vector 1 2 3. There is another vector c2 2 3 4. Now I want to combine these two vectors together column wise. It is not row wise, column wise. So I have created c3. See, it combined the vector column wise. And similarly, we have R bind. R bind basically combine the vectors with row wise. So see, similarly, we can have these two. It combine the element the row wise. Fine. So that's it for today. Hope you like this session.